Hey Oakham students, Ben Asman here. Welcome to Organic Chemistry Lab. This is our very first experiment. It is melting point analysis. Let's get to it. Okay, what do you need to know for today for melting point analysis? One is that this only affects soluble impurities. If you have a soluble impurity, one that dissolves, as opposed to something like glass or metal, it's not going to dissolve in an organic compound. But if you have something soluble, like another organic compound, and you introduce it, two things are going to happen. One, it's going to decrease the average melting point, and two, it's going to widen that range. Now, we say point, but really a melting point is a range. It has a start, it has an end. We start off from, for instance, for my example here, from 111.2 to 113.1 degrees C, of course, and for that you have the starting point, which is, oh, you just began to see it like melt a little bit to now it's a full liquid. Now for these, if you have a soluble impurity, we see a decrease of the average. So here we have a decrease that a major decrease for an impure compound with a soluble impurity, that 103 to 108.3. Now that is massive decrease and a range increase. So this had a range of about a little bit more than 1, a little less than 2, and this has a range greater than 5. That is a massive increase in range. Therefore, we would expect this to be an impure product. Now, how do we actually do it? Let's get through that. Okay, so when you're actually doing this, what are you gonna do? So first, what we have here is your first one is gonna be your unknown only. So let's say you get your unknown only, you make that, and you end up with 84 to 85 degrees C. Great number, you end up right there. So now, what you're gonna do is take those, look at your table, and you're gonna find things which are plus and minus from that. Because guess what, you're not gonna do it perfect the first time, it's not gonna be exact, you just wanna be kind of in the ballpark, plus or minus a few degrees, and you find three standards, maybe two, okay, but three standards that you are going to then pick, and you're gonna make three mixes. Okay, three 50-50 mixes. So in this case, we have standard number one, standard number two, and standard number three, each one mixed with your unknown. And if we look at these, we have standard number three got 60 to 75, big gap, big wide range, drop in temperature, that's probably not it. Here, standard number two mix got 53 to 58, also big drop, not probably it. And then we have here standard number one. Now that one, you do see a small drop. It's not perfect, but it's still relatively close and it's the right amount. That's probably the one we wanna do. How do we verify that? We do one last run. Our last run here is gonna be the unknown, a 50-50 mix, and our standard only. So what that means is if we have all three of these, unknown only, standard only, and 50-50 mix of the two, if all three of them melt at the exact same time, we know that's the same thing. And if for our example here, they did 85 to 86, once again, not the same exactly, but in the same range, that is probably our compound. Okay, for the initial demo, we are going to need the transcinnamic acid. We'll take a little bit of that. You never need nearly as much as you think you do. You just need enough for the capillary tube. That is even overkill. We are then gonna make sure our spatula is clean. So now we're gonna grab our urea. Get a little bit more urea. There we go. Once again, make sure our spatula is clean. And the mixture is already made for you, so you don't have to make this mixture. You will have to make your own mixture for the other ones, but not for this one. So here's the mixture for the two. That one's already done for you. Lovely. Now we do want to, as much as possible, make this as fine as possible. So that it, one, melts more evenly, and two, actually goes into the capillary tube. Same thing here. Yep, If you skip this step, which nobody remembers to tell you, you will have some issues. All the points won't be quite as precise. They will work, just won't be quite as good. Okay, make a nice little pile so that it's easy to scoop up. Same thing after wiping I did with the other one. Wipe. Now for our capillary tubes, in this case, we want about a few, about a millimeter, give or take. This particular one is not very fine, so I kind of have to scoop it in. This is the urea. Okay. That should be plenty. And then we're going to kind of whack it against the table there to get it to go down to the bottom. Repeat for the other ones. Once again, you don't want to overdo it. You want to fill it to the top. You just want, there we go, a good amount in there. See roughly what it's like. Okay. And last but not least, that one. This is the tranexamic acid. Once again, you can see what that's like. Lovely. Okay, this is your melting point apparatus. Make sure it's plugged in here and in the front. Now, if you look here, there are three different slots that you could fit one of these capillary tubes. Let me put one of them in there so you can see it. So that is where they fit. And that big hole there, that's for the thermometer. And then right there, there's your viewing port. Let's add our other two. Make sure they are in the correct order. You don't want to lose track of which one's which. Okay. There we go. Now we're going to start this off. Turn that on. You can see the light there. And we're going to start this off at, let's say, 6. Okay. And then once we reach about 100, we're going to turn that down to 4. Thank you. Then when this is done, you're ready to cool this down, connect your tube to the pressurized air, take it, and then which is going to blow it down the sides and down here to cool it off.